Hello and welcome. I am Exit Light and this is my channel. Today we're going to go down a very strange path. A very strange yet true path. These are true stories that have happened, and some of them may make your skin crawl a bit. So before that, if you would please give this video a thumbs up, I would really appreciate it. And if you are not subscribed and you would like to be, there's no better time than today. Also, if you'd like to be notified when my content goes live, go ahead and click that bell. And now, let's take part in some of the strangest and creepiest true stories you'll likely ever encounter. Number one, it's about a deadly exorcism. In August of 2016 in North London, a 26-year-old Kennedy Ife began acting strange and aggressive following a pain in his throat. He reportedly bit his father and threatened to cut off his own penis. Then he complained of a python or a snake inside of him before his family restrained him to a bed with cable ties and excess force. Then, as one would do, the family set out about attempting to cure Kennedy through restraint and prayer over the next 3 days, as was told to the court. His brother, Colin Ife, told the police that it's clear that thing was in him. What we believe was a demon, because it was not natural. It was clearly trying to kill him, he said. We had to restrain him for himself. It was clear if we didn't restrain him, he could have tried to harm people in our family. Kennedy Ife had been bound to his bed for 3 days without medical attention when his brother finally called emergency services. And he explained that Kennedy Ife was complaining of being dehydrated. He appeared to have developed breathing issues and ended up being pronounced dead at 10:17 in the morning. It was reported in the newspaper that while the police were at the house, Colin Ife allegedly tried to carry out an attempted resurrection of his brother by chanting and praying for Mr. Ife to come alive. All seven of Kennedy Ife's family members were accused of manslaughter, false imprisonment, and causing or allowing the death of a vulnerable adult. Post-mortem examination revealed that there were 60 wounds on Kennedy's body, including a bite. His father, Kenneth Ife, along with four of his brothers, sustained injuries as well. The BBC reported that Kenneth Ife told jurors he ordered his sons to take shifts and use overwhelming force, but denied an association with cults, the occult, and secret societies, and said they played no part in the death of his son. The jury deliberated for 4 days. That's when they came back and said that all seven family members were cleared of charges on March 14th, 2019. Our next one. When the Brett Seuss family decided to insulate their home in Auburn, Pennsylvania in 2015, they discovered that it had already been insulated, so to speak. What happened was they found out their walls had been stuffed with tons of dead animal carcasses. The news reported that the dead animals were wrapped in newspapers from the 1930s and 40s and were among half-used spices and other items. After removing the items, they sent hundreds of artifacts and carcasses to an expert in Kutztown. The expert explained that the rotting animals in their walls are related to pow-pow, or Dutch magic, a ritual originating in the culture of the Pennsylvania Dutch to treat ailments and gain physical and spiritual protection. The Pennsylvania Dutch were a group of German-speaking settlers to Pennsylvania in the 16th and 1700s and are often of Lutheran, Mennonite, or Amish faiths. The Washington Post wrote an article about the magic, saying that many of the spells deal with the care of livestock, finding water, or the treatment of minor ailments, reflecting the conditions and concerns of those early American settlers. But powwow has within it a tradition of darker spells, and even of such things as conjuring demons. One notable ritual in their tradition is this hex, which is said to create loyalty in a dog. To attach a dog to a person, provided nothing else was used before to affect it, try to draw some of your blood and let the dog eat it along with his food, and he will stay with you. Perhaps that's because he now sees you as potential food. The mold that was found on the rotting carcasses in the home has caused illness among the family members, and they say that the odor won't go away. Our next one is friends of Danielle Harkins, who was a 35-year-old school teacher near St. Petersburg, Florida. They began to notice that she was acting strangely. In June of 2012, she suddenly began developing an interest in demonic rituals. Soon after this started, she was arrested for abuse of 7 of her former students. The Tampa Bay Times reported that Danielle Harkins told the kids they needed to rid their bodies of demons, and as the group gathered before dusk on a Saturday around a small fire pit near the St. Petersburg Pier, she told them that they should cut their skin to let the evil spirits out. Police said she told the children then they needed to burn the wounds to ensure that those spirits would not return. As a side note, world's strictest teacher. Then, when Harkins held a lighter to one teen's hand, the wind blew the flame out, police said. That prompted her to douse his hand in perfume before setting it on fire. The boy suffered second-degree burns. Another teen was cut on the neck with a broken bottle. Harkins used a flame to heat a small key, which she then used to cauterize the wound. The police were notified because a friend of one of the students who participated in the ritual raised alarms. The parents of the boy with the second-degree wounds, that didn't raise alarms. However, none of the students themselves told their parents about the event or would comment following the arrest of Harkins for aggravated battery and child abuse. Investigators said that they had spoken to Harkins, but she didn't spell out what, play on words, what type of religion would require such drastic measures. She hasn't informed us exactly what she was trying to accomplish with this, said St. Petersburg Police Department. Our next one. In September of 2014, a Utah teen returned to his home to find his parents and his 3 siblings dead. There was a notebook, and in the notebook was a to-do list. The to-do list included feed the pets, find someone to watch after the house. It looked as if the parents were going on a vacation. However, it appeared to be a murder-suicide. There were never any clues. There was not a suicide note. No prior indication that they would do this, and no explanation was left. Police were stumped, trying to figure out why these parents would kill themselves and 3 out of their 4 children. The case remained unsolved for a year. No one knew what happened. No one could think of what could drive these parents to do something so unthinkable without any provocation. However, in January, police released some chilling details in the case. According to accounts from family members and an investigation by the police, the parents were driven by a belief that the apocalypse was coming and an obsession with a convicted killer. Friends and family told police that the parents were worried about the evil in the world and wanted to escape a pending apocalypse. But most of their family assumed that they just wanted to move somewhere off the grid. Investigators also found letters written by Christy Stracht to one of the state's most infamous convicted killers, Dan Lafferty. He was convicted in the 1984 fatal stabbing of a sister-in-law and her one-year-old daughter. According to his trial testimony, he killed the victims at the order of his brother, Ron Lafferty, who claimed to have had a revelation from God. The story became a book called Under the Banner of Heaven. Police said Christy Stracht became friends with Dan Lafferty, and she and her husband even visited him in prison. Our final one. In 2007, ABC News documented a series of cell phone calls to families with terrifyingly specific death threats. The unidentified callers knew exactly what families were doing and what they were wearing. Families said that the calls would come in at all hours of the night, threatening to kill their children or their pets or their grandparents. Voicemails arrived, playing recordings of their private conversations, including one with a local police detective. The caller knows, the family said, what they're wearing and what they're doing. And after months of investigating, the police seemed powerless to stop them. This went on with the Kuykendall family for months. They reported to the police that the caller had a scratchy voice and was threatening to slit their throats. When the Faircrest, Washington police tried to find the culprit, the calls were traced back to the Kuykendall's own phones, even when they were turned off. The Kuykendall's and two other Faircrest families told ABC News that they believe the callers were using their cell phones to spy on them. They say the hackers know their every move, where they are, what they're doing, what they're saying, what they're wearing, who they're with. And the callers have recorded private conversations. Now, if that doesn't make you want to put your cell phone down right this minute and stomp on it or put it down your garbage disposal, I don't know what does. I get mad when I talk about a cereal and pretty soon I'm getting ads for it on Facebook. Thank you for coming to this channel. Please go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. And I hope you sleep well tonight.